introductions or something for the organizers to have on this very wonderful conference. So it's my pleasure to hear about the book. Today I am talking about some regularity result from linear parabolic problems with a metadata. So here, the main problem I only dealing with the linear groups or nonlinear problems, but the Peter-Blaschian type, like a polynomial groups, also working, should work. But for the sake of a complexity, I just take a linear groups, but the same idea and approach is working. Okay, so. So the problem. So this is a typical quadrilinear and parabolic problems. And the main thing is here on the right hand side, we have a measure. This is a signed log measure. Okay, so here we deal with a bounded domain with a non smooth boundary. Also, the, here, this is the space time domain. So I don't deal with the time dependent. Also, time-dependent domain, also we can handle also. But here, mu is a signed log measure in a finite mass. Then, the main structure goes to here, non-linearity, and the A has, like here, just a linear course. And also, it has electricity condition. Standard oscillations. So he has a monopolistic property. So typical like a min-t-trig approach or make a compact this method is working in this game. But then let me start with some geometric notations. Like here. So the variable is a space and the time. And I am dealing with some measurable coefficient. So I separate the space variable. This is the normal direction, and this is a tangential direction. So this is my tangential direction, let me say x prime. And this is, let me say this is normal direction, x1. And this is a time direction. And here, the main assumption in this talk is that with respect to this tangential and the time variable here, I will give just a small BM assumptions. But along this normal direction here, I give some, actually there is no regulated assumption. Main assumption here in this direction, x prime time, so small BM assumptions. But in this direction, we have almost a very similar property, but wrong in this normal direction, there is no regularity. So the property can be jumping around this one direction. So this is the typical cases when you are studying like a composite materials, something like that. So in this way, there are many applications. Okay, so then standard notation comes up here. This is a point, and tangential. This is ball, and tangential normal. I would say this is a cubes and a cylinder, and this is a tangential and time direction I denote prime. Also, since I am dealing with the measure data, so this denotes the space of a signed log measure. That is the dual space of a like a CC omega t. another key word in this talk is Munken hope rate. So I think that many of you are very familiar with that. So this is rate means that positive or local integral. And this is AAP rate means that also W belongs to L minus 1 over 2P minus 1. The p equals infinite, p equals 1 is a strong distortion, minus 1. Okay, so the typical example is that you can find here. So we can operate also is widely studied in the area of harmonic analysis, so that metal maximal function is bound in one eye, and it turns out that this is rate 8 is the optimal assumption for some very nice graph. So another here, the limiting case, p equals infinite, that is a infinite rate. So there are some three definitions, they are equivalent, but here I would take this definition, is that this is a Lebesgue measure, this is a rate measure, but the ratio is a slope, it's a relatively comparable, that is a infinite. This is a standard definition. Also, this can be another definition. Okay, we can easily practice definition. This is true. Okay. So here, we treated this assumption A infinite because this is the weakest in the one can operate. And another keyword is Hollinger space. Okay, so to introduce Hollinger space, so here there is a young function. A young function, like in the previous talk, like a capital S, or in the like yesterday talk by Brian Idol, this is a B. That is a young function, or we call M function. So that is it. It should be convex and non decreasing. Satisfy the distortion like this one. And also, then in this literature, the necessary and sufficient assumption could be this delta 2 assumption. Delta 2 assumption. It means that it is a doubling assumption, so it does not, like 2TT, does not decay so fast. And another one is a lambda 2 condition. Means that, like in here, I have this one. It means that the function does not decay so fast. And the delta 2, lambda 2, they are very close. Okay. If you have this young function, then we can define its complementary function. So young function, delta 2 implies that its complete function is lambda 2. So also we know that with this assumption, the maximal function is bounded. So in some sense, this is necessary and sufficient in the literature in this space. So we can say this is a very generalized LP space. Okay. Then. So here is some examples, like exponential space, it does not satisfy delta 2 condition, so we have to exclude. Also, like log here, it does not satisfy number of 2 conditions. But if you take a power here, 1 plus epsilon, then we can include them. So like here, this is a typical example. In this case, the corresponding space is the Lebesgue space. Okay, so the result here in this frame already extend the result in the standard LP regularity. Also, because of the presence of a weight, we cannot wait. We are free to choose any some necessary weight. Then we can improve also, like the borderline case also we can do more. So, The result is very broad, but the approach is very simple. As I am speaking here. Okay. So, the space, the underlying space is the so called awaited void space. Okay. So that the function f satisfies this, this is finite. But that we know that with this modular inequality, this cannot be unknown. So instead, we use this kind of Luxembourg norm. So with this norm, so this space is a complete modular space. And also, it turns out that with this nice assumption, and this is we can operate, and this integrates one and this norm from the AI equivalent. Okay, so this is some inverse constant here. And they are comparable to each other. So in this case, you can play with either this form or this form. No problem. So it depends on each case. So in some case, I use this one. In other case, I use this one. Okay, so if I play with the normalization or scaling, this is much better because this is known. So here is Professor Okada here. So the first main issue is about the existence. But right now, the existence issue is so advanced. Actually, Professor Okada, he did many things here. The president here. Of course, for the linear case, it is easier just to do anything argument and the LP theory actually is working. Even for the NPDs, starting here, then back here, and 75, same linear, and then Professor Bucardo and Reynolds and his group, actually, I would say they do a lot. So, thanks to him, our groups. So I don't worry about the existence. So it goes. Okay. So elliptic probably. And there are very nice existences. Okay. So we are dealing with this measure. And also this does not belong to the dual space of a standard, like a big solution space. So we need a broader concept of a solution. Here I would say this is a solar. That is a solution obtained by a linked over approximation. Okay, so the first is L1W11. Like a P operation, you see this is P minus 1. The solar means that belongs to here, and this has a linear growth gradient, so belongs to L1. This is what is in the sense of this direction. This is the first assumption. Okay, and then approximation, because this is approximation. Moreover, there exist a sequence of a solution to, like this is the so called regular or approximating problems. Such that here comes here, strong convergence. But you can, this is a bigger than number, this number, but for our purpose, I just choose one here. See here, strong convergence means that it goes almost everywhere convergence. But here at K, belongs a convergent view in the sense of nature. And also, we can extend outside the zero, so we can assume that the measure is defined everywhere. Okay. So there are two steps. Regular problems is normal weak solution. And then the limit is a convergence, is a strong convergence, L1. And this norm under control of this norm is L1 norm. Okay, this is very important. So, summing up here.
regard the right-hand side FK as a sequence over smooth function
because we have a convolution.
A convolution. Modification that this is a complex function. But it is still the rundown. So we will not do that. Okay. Also, here we do need here strong convergence L1 space.
So we are in the sense of every computation is in L1 sense.
Okay, but the uniqueness is, of course, is not solved still. Open problems. Okay, so instead of some other concept like denormalized solution or entropy solution, then we can talk about the uniqueness. But in the range of solar, the uniqueness is still open problems. Then, so another keyword might be the most important keyword is a pressure maximal function of order. Because the left hand side, I have a two derivative, and the right hand side, zero, but the left hand side gradient u, so there is one difference, one order, so this order is. Actually comes. So this is the definition of a fractional maximal function. And you can think about for the linear case. As this is very close to rich potential of order one. This is an infinite sense, this is L1 sense. So this is more precise definitions so that we have these relations. Also, we have this relation for every piece, they give you the one. But p equals one, you have a weak time estimate. So I have found that some professor Kiplet and Sigmund has a very nice paper. So if you are interested in this fractional maximum function as a rich potential, then I strongly recommend to this paper. This is very, very good. This is in the range of measure, but not the properties, I say. Okay. So here then, we have some conclusion that, okay, so higher regularity means that I have a measure u here, then we can define m and u. Then I have a solution gradient u. Okay. So then the main question is whether they are equivalent, right? So gradient u, here, and I say here, in the m1 u. It's some space. So p equals L1 space. There is no regulator substance. Here, just according to structural theory, we have existence and the strong convergence, then we have the standard estimate here. But if this space is getting better and better, like in LP space, P is getting larger and larger, we might need some strong assumptions on the nonlinearity and also the boundary of the domain. And the question is, after I miss the question is, what would be the least regularity requirement so that still we have this estimate also? This is the main problem in this talk. So, on the other end, so here even my talk is about like LP, some space, like higher integrability. But another thing is very important to have here is a point. Gradient point-wise potential estimate. Also, this is a very important area in the regulator theory. Okay, so here I just listed many results in these directions. So this, the work starts from Benjola,
very recently, actually, for the elite case, but that is without S dependence, that is autonomous problems.
And this elliptic problems extended to Georgia and the Minnesota. And also, for the primary case, for the primary one, also we have the is ST, ST dependence, and of course in Minnesota, it is most of the likely rather either respect or reach potential or open potential for the pyroflasia. And the Baroni and also the pyroflasia extended to generalized pyroflastic case. It has oligic growth conditions. And recently, with my students, we extended the point was estimated some to more general PD, like here, PS aplasia, also in the double phase problems. Double phase problems that you have LP energy, and you have another very close LQ energy, and add some, like, continuous, hold a continuous function together. So this is the case in market, but still we can handle it. So for the same problem with the linear growth with my student Kim, and we did also reach a potential estimate. Okay, but here the difference from this work is that the linear here input depends on you. So because of you, it's really difficult, not too difficult, but very complicated. You have to handle this one. Even though this goes to the limit. And also, assumption is here. So we allow the coefficients to be measurable. Right? So, according to the very well known example by Mayer, even for the linear problems, we cannot allow two variables in the just measurement. We only allow only one variable. So, in that sense, this is the optimal condition. So, one variable. It's just a measurable, but the other variables should be some other numeric assumption. Here we have a small VM assumption. So, first we need the energy estimate here. Actually, this energy estimate is a part of the heat flow everything. So, it's just a change from the right hand side in either respect to maximum pumps or the one. So it means that P equals 1 L1 space, so we have a standard estimate. And here, Calderon's unique type estimates is that we are interested in proving a global Calderon's unique type estimate for a solar U in the setting of a weighted orbit space. Okay, so the given data here is your position space by delta 2 W. Then we can achieve the assumption. First, the weight is a little bit less than the A weight. And of course, C is a universal constant and they only depend on data, independent from solution and also the density. So the question is we want to optimize, means the minimal conditions on both nonlinearity and the domain for the desired displacement. So some, there are some results in these directions. So the pyroflasian types is Professor Cook, he proved in this paper very recently. And with my students Oak and Park, we have been able to extend to PX pyroflasian. Also for the linear growth, we are playing with the intersection of all variable X possibilities also. So, but the parabolic problems, because all every user are very new ones, so as high as I am concerned, there is no result known for the parabolic case in the literature. So, you can do it here in this area. For the parabolic problems, so the problem is we need to define how we can define parabolic range. Because for the parabolic problem, we don't have a scaling problem there. So
So we have to play in the intrinsic geometry and the intrinsic limits that could make the problems more difficult. But now the intrinsic geometry is now very well understood. So you might do more, even for the parabolic case. Because for the parabolic problems, my pointwise estimate is very well known. So why not for this case? We can do that. Okay. So here is the assumption. Okay, so as I told earlier, the main assumption is here in tangential time, small beam assumption, but the x1 direction, there's no regularity. Also, domain is I put some fractal boundary. So the assumption means that either this I, you can take any number because the problem has a scaling property. And the delta, we can choose a layer that is sufficiently small. So the definition here, so non-linearity, it has a linear growth with a repeat QG, just divide by QG, and take a suprema. Okay, then we don't worry about the QG variables. Then I have a 1, 2, 3 variables, and here in this variable, so small beam assumption, like here, but here there is no assumption. This delta means that this is a small beam assumption. So this function has a small beam assumption. Okay, so then the limiting problem, we can teach it tangential at the time, and non-linear only depend on solution gradient and only one x1 variable. Then we can play, we can handle in this case, because we can linearize, and then we can use the DJOG to have some Lipschitz regularity for the limiting problems. I will come back later. Okay. And the domain is the so-called Lyapunov-Pratt domain. So it means that any points on the boundary you can choose, and any size R, any point, any size, then you can see the boundary. But that you just a hyperplane passing through the point. Such that the scale, the distance between like, the boundary and the hyperplane is a sufficiently small. Of course, d is a Hausdorff distance. This is the definition of the Lyapunov-Pratt domain. And so I think that Professor Ruiz has very nice results for the Pinaplacian in terms of this kind of Lyapunov-Pratt. So it might be this domain is optimal domain, but not optimal, optimal domain in the regularity theory. So small beam and the Lyapunov-Pratt means that. So delta R, I said deltas can be chosen sufficiently small, R can be any number, and this means that epsilon. I said small BMO and no regularity in the x1 direction. On the end, the domain is a Lyapunov-Pratt. It means that the boundary can be trapped into two hyperplanes. Okay, so the boundary could be very rough. Or it's just you can simply say that what is a Lyapunov-Pratt domain? Lyapunov-Pratt domain is extension of a Lipschitz domain. The Lipschitz constant is sufficiently small. Okay, so if you have some result in the Lipschitz domain, either sufficiently small Lipschitz constant, then the result should be extended to this Lyapunov-Pratt domain also. So, yeah, actually, in the earlier, like 10 years ago, we have proved that. With the professor Leon, we have proved that the fact that you have a Lyapunov-Pratt domain. If you are sitting a little inside of the domain, okay, epsilon distance, then the epsilon distance domain is a Lipschitz domain. So in the small epsilon neighborhood, we can play with a Lipschitz domain, and then we can relatively easily can prove some estimate, and that limit epsilon goes to zero, and the result should be working in some sense. Not always, but course, this has the so-called meta-density conditions. So the nice property, like the extension property, or sort of embedding, or correct, some kind of necessary inequality should be true on this domain. Okay. And here is the main result. As I told that, so the weight A implied, and this is Young function, then this is true. Okay. But the thing is that for sufficiently small data, and this data can be computed explicitly in the middle of the proof. Also, the good thing is that once we have this proof, then a direct consequence is a version of this result is here in the variable S1 of the space here. Okay, so there are two ways you can directly prove here. But it could be very complicated. But this is very simple. So first the proof of this one, and then the corollary here in this one. Okay, before I don't know the result here, the property here. We have tried to prove this one. It seems very complicated. But once we know, we try first this one. And then this is just direct match answer. Okay. So now start. The main important part is comparison estimate. Because the main approach is based on the approximation element. As I have assumptions. With the assumptions, I can play with the limiting PD, and it turns out the limiting PD has a Lipschitz regularity. And then I can compare the solution, of course, the localized solution, and the corresponding to the limiting PD, which has a Lipschitz regularity. And I can compute the difference. For the in the range of the weak solution, everything is very well known. Okay, but here, knowing that we are considering metadata. So on that step, we should be very careful. Okay, once done, then everything is the same. Okay, but thanks to the here, the well-known result and the advanced results, including Professor Ocardo, so we can apply and to do some computations, and we can handle. Anyway, this is first we can in the regular problems here, but the thing is that this is L1 long is finite, and this is finite, and this is L1, right? This weight is defined in this way, and for the sake of simplicity, we just omit the k. Okay, but in the computation, this is in the range of weak solutions, but the only difference is L1 space, not L2 space. This is the difference. Okay. And then, perturbation element, okay, not based element. We derive local, interior, and the boundary estimates. This is for gradient here, by comparison with the limiting equations here. Okay. Why this is the limiting equation? Because the boundary. The Lyapunov flat domain is very close to hyperplane. So here, just plus here. So x1 equals 0. And the other variable, like the tangential variable and the time variable, can be predicted. So this is only dependent on the x1 variable. Then the next question is, how can you prove the Lipschitz regularity? Actually, I have proved this problem for a long, long time. About more than 5 years, but finally we are successful in proving this one. It turns out the idea is very simple. Very simple. For the linear case, I have x1 here. So I'm taking the different variable, like x2, x3, and the differentiate. Then we have the limiting, the linear problems. Then apply to DJOT. Means that gradient with respect to the tangential variable has a Hodel regularity. Then how about the x1 variable? Then once I have a linear problem, just separate tangential and the normal. Then A1, A3, X1 is quadratic. And then I use A1 as an elliptic condition to show that A1 also bound to produce finally. And also, this is a reflection argument is working. So, this is also major obstacles to prove higher integrity, but this is already very low. There is now no, so we can go further. Okay? So, here is the proof. We first localize, right? We can take any point, any size. It could be inside, could be around the boundary. Inside the part can be easily handled. Once I can handle the other boundary, then just localize. Of course, you can take this is a 1-1-1 because scaling. I have a scaling property. So this comes from regulated distribution. The boundary can be trapped into two hyperplanes, x1 equals 0. And this is a small distribution. Means that the PDE is very close to the limiting PDE. Also here, in the radar, I can take one good point. One good point means that on that point here, I pick the good point just as zero. At zero, this is a small. M1U is small. Okay. Good point means that this is small. Also, gradient U, this is an integral average. At the center zero, this is a neighborhood bound. So domain is very close to half of plane, and the nonlinear only depend on x1 variable, and the right hand side equals 0 means they're almost homogeneous programs. Also, I have a uniform L1 bound. This is the assumption. With this assumption, we can do comparison. First step is this is a delicate part. This is homogeneous programs. The changes you start from measure U, actually L1 from 0. Then, but we can do that because there are many nice uniform estimates here, L1. And it turns out that it's less than here. And my assumption that this is smaller. This means that solution U is very close to homogeneous problem. In the L1 sense. And then next we can move this L1, and the next limiting PDE is in the should go to in the L2 space so that we can play with the weaker solutions. But here there is a higher integrability. This is bounded by gradient U, this is bounded by gradient U. Here L2 is bounded. So this is in the range of a weaker solution. And we can go forward here. Okay, so homogeneous problems is very close to here. Right, this is the limiting PDE. Well, it is the solution to the limiting PDE. They are very close. So you put together my trial and inequality. So my solution U is very close to limiting PDE. Each had a Lipschitz regularity. Okay. Then the remaining part is computation. Okay. So I put together. So this is just I can say that if smallness is sufficiently small, then the solution, solar solution, is very close to limiting PDE, V, which has a Lipschitz regularity. Of course, this is a localized one. So next, we need a nice covering argument. And also, the main approach here, I use the maximal function here. This is a standard definition of maximal function. Okay, also, it has a big one-line estimate. But this is in the sense of a parabolic, because of our assumption, I take this as C. Tangential angle moment, that's not all. This is cubes. Okay. And this is the so called vitality type covering. And also this is, you might be most of your day familiar with decomposition. I don't know about the decomposition. So it's one, so I have two sets here. So let's say. And this one has a smallest distribution. And another one is the covering distributions. Then this can be considered a dictionary. This is very close to Kailana geomorphic decomposition. But the difference here, usually we use a numerical measure, but this is weight, Munkin over weight. But this Munkin over weight are satisfied by the implicit Carlos conditions, they are compatible with each other. So by using that assumption, you can prove some. So the proof is very simple, just if you can prove a Kailana geomorphic decomposition or a Vitali covering number, this you can. So to the our setting, so I put C. Like this is because I want to control this one. This is a better setting. I will find the radar in much way, and the D is here. Okay. I can choose radar delta. And this is the lambda. This is the second conditions of the Vitali covering lambda. So how we can prove this one? Usually I use a proof by contradiction. Means that if not, so this if not means that if I have a one point belongs to here, not here, then this is a contradiction. I prove this one. So I'm starting right here. That is one good point. It belongs to here, not here. So it means that, okay, the point does not belong to here. Means that gradient U less than one. This is maximum function in any direction. This is a bounded. Also, the negation is less than here. So earlier, I said one good point means that the point is gradient U is bounded and the F is sufficient is one. And then with another assumption, like a very flat and a small beam assumption, so my PD is very close to limiting PD. Then this means that this is almost uniformly bounded. Then I can easily show that the measure is just zero to reach the contradiction. And this is the proof. Might be very technical, but the idea is really simple. Okay. Then this is, I changed to the setting of our problems. And then also to apply the Vitali covering lemma. So also we need the first assumption. Like this is the smallest assumption. But assuming that I have this one, then you can prove this kind of a power decay estimate. First of all, I let hash that is K plus 1. And the normalize I am here and then here. And we keep iteration equals to keep AK here. This once we do have this kind of power decay estimate. With respect to here, MDU, also with our weights, and once I have this one, it's almost done. And then, this is a classical theory. This is in the meta theory one, in any textbook, in the harmonic analysis, I can find this. F is a measurable function, and this is a keyword number. F belongs to weighted weight space, even on a summation with respect to here. Like upper level set measure is finite, and this is the relation. So if I can show that capital S is bounded, and this is bounded, so the main thing is just to prove that this is bounded, but we do have this one. as a power decay as we just mirrored here, and computation. Okay, so, so before that, so we do need the smallest solution, the first solution of the Vitalian coupling and the smallest solution. To prove this one, we first normalize the right hand side. We just normalize the divide by this term and multiply by delta. This is true. Then the first condition comes here. So weight changing the vacuum measure. Okay. This is one I put here. So universal constant. And this is the condition. This is standard error estimate. And this is delta. Later I can choose any option so that this is to take delta. So this is this one. Okay, so the first assumption of the Vitalian coupling lemma is true. And then second, so I want to prove this is finite. And the first, this term, how we can handle? Because this has a delta 2 conditions. Right? We can change here. Okay, so this is a universal constant. Still I have here how k is getting larger. But what's the we can handle? Then the computations here is this is the just this is a simple computation, and I plug here the power decay estimate. And then for the computation, because m and u is less than delta, so this is uniformly bounded. And I reached here. Okay, this is a geometric space. Okay, and one is a universal constant, and the epsilon is here. So, universal constant, I have epsilon. I have to choose given. Take so that this is 1/2. Then we can first determine epsilon. Then according to comparison estimate, that is the delta. So that is power decay estimate. Then it turns out this is finite. And the result is true. So the approach is, actually, when I was a graduate student, I have proved a long time ago. Still, I am using this approach sometimes because this sometimes is very, very reliable and the approach is easier to handle. So, but this approach is one. This is an older approach, actually. And then, yeah, thank you very much.